Good morning. This is Larry Ripka, CEO of the Valmark Financial Group. I want to talk this morning about an anticipated announcement by the Principal Financial Group to close out and abandon some elements of its U.S. life and annuity business. In February of this year, Principal announced a strategic review of its life and annuity businesses prompted by activist investor Elliott Management. The announcement this week by Principal answers the question that I posed last month in my post entitled The Great Call, which, by the way, had almost 3,000 views. Low bond yields are forcing U.S. life insurance companies to raise capital or leave the business. Principal Life has been a great carrier partner over the years and a real innovator in the use of accelerated underwriting for term and a key player in the non-qualified markets using variable COLI products. Principal also had the misfortune of selling large blocks of mispriced universal life with secondary guarantees. We've always liked the culture and people at Principal, but we've long been suspicious of the capital structure where most of the general accounts products were issued by the thinly capitalized Principal National Life. Just like policyholders who purchased policy from MedInvestors Life were not really getting MetLife, or Security Life of Denver were not really getting ING, policyholders were not buying a policy from Principal, but Principal National. For these policyholders, there was always a risk of being cast off from the mothership. This was especially true when it came to universal life with secondary guarantees. Principal supported this product line financially with captive reinsurance arrangements that pushed the true cost of paying for this into future accounting periods. Well, today, those future accounting periods have arrived, especially with changes to GAAP accounting for long-dated products like this. On Monday, June 28th, Principal announced in a press release that it would, quote, discontinue sales of U.S. retail fixed annuities and consumer life insurance products. The press release also said that Principal would, quote, pursue strategic alternatives, including divestiture for the in-force universal life with secondary guarantees block, approximately $7 billion of policy reserves, as well as other related in-force blocks, unquote. It announced in a separate communication to agents and distributors that going forward, products will only be available for the business market as defined by non-qualified deferred compensation plans, life insurance supporting Principal's business owner and executive solutions or BOS strategy, and any life insurance plans administered on their BMA platform. It will also still allow affiliated business, which includes personal insurance on business owners and key executives. So what are we to make of this announcement? Is the company exiting the business or part of it? In the Great Call post that I did last month, I detailed how the press of low bond yields is forcing companies to make one of three decisions: post new capital and stay in the business, fold their hand and exit the business, or pass on the cards in some form of spin-off. So which of these is signaled by Principal's announcement? It says to me that Principal is folding most of the products built on its general account because they simply require too much capital. In an Alert ratings report this week on Principal, Alert reported that the business lines being abandoned account for 6% of premiums, but 39% of the company's reserves. The block of universal life with secondary guarantees represents the worst cards in this losing hand. The intention to pursue strategic alternatives including a divestiture, signal they want to close on this bet and pass it on to someone else, likely private equity. In this week's Life Product Review, Bobby Samuelson also wrote about principal and speculated that the spinoff might be to Elliott's own Prosperity Life Reinsurer. Principal may follow Voya's lead and sell to a company like Resolution Life. In my post, I detailed just how much companies are likely to lose from these blocks of universal life and falling interest rates. In fact, I dug up an article I wrote 16 years ago that predicted and quantified just this kind of risk. That article in the Journal of Financial Services Professionals was entitled Guesses, Promises, and Guarantees. At the time in the article, I quoted Jeff Moorweiser of Fitch Rating Services, who said that if interest rates went down and stayed down, that the industry might need an additional $50 to $100 billion of capital to backfill the gap that captive reinsurance arrangements created. No wonder that last month, Ernst & Young, in a survey of life insurance CFOs, reported more than half were considering divestiture in 2 years. So what does that mean for policyholders, particularly with principal? For those who have separate account products issued by principal, this is close to a non-event. The biggest losers will be those policyholders with universal life with secondary guarantees. We'll have to wait and see what happens to that block. We'll also need to wait and see how business owners are defined in terms of what products we will still have available with principal. I hope we don't lose what is the best accelerated underwriting program in the market. On several occasions, I've said that this interest rate environment creates extreme challenges for all insurance companies, whether they're stock, mutual, or private equity owned. These gap accounting changes are putting more immediate pressure on public companies like Principal. But in the long term, it's impossible for any life company to build compelling products for consumers with bonds that only yield 3 or 3.25%. Ultimately, no insurance company can offer a product that produces better returns than the underlying financial instruments that back them. One of my favorite quotes of all time comes from Dan Sullivan, who said, "All progress begins with telling the truth." For advisors who really want to tell the truth and help their clients make good decisions, here are 4 lessons we can learn from Principal. Producers ask me, which companies, Larry, are safe? My answer is you must choose safer products rather than guessing at who will be safer companies 10 years from now, because so much can change, as we've seen just this year with Ohio National, ING, and now Principal. I've demonstrated in previous posts that separate account variable products are indeed safer in the long run because the insurance company can change less things with them. And it's almost 100% of what I've chosen to own personally. Second, recommend products that give your clients flexibility. Things change both for the client and on the side of the insurance company. Agents are not doing their clients any favor when they compare premiums from companies with 30 years of fixed premium and no cash value. Third, ongoing service is the biggest part of the real value creation as a life insurance professional. That's why we at Valmark have created our own policy management company to help our firms deliver on this element of life insurance 10X. And finally, we need to make recommendations that really are in the client's best long-term interest, not what's most expedient for ourselves or what carriers are pushing. This means taking time to really help the client make an informed decision and not just passing on something that sounds good, like an illustration with IUL at the AG 49 limit. it also means going the extra mile and doing the things that really create value, including diversifying coverage for a client, even though this means more work. If you really want to understand some of the math of what I described today, I highly recommend this article from the Journal of Financial Services Professionals. We got a box of reprints and they've set in our storage room, but I am glad to send you it to anyone who asks for it. It is copyrighted material, but you can contact Brandy at our office or just email me, and we are glad to provide this. There's lessons to be learned from what happened with Principal and some of the other carriers, and I really do think some of those lessons could make us better. At the Valmark Financial Group, we bring the golden rule to life, and this means creating insurance plans that we would buy ourselves, and we're dedicated to helping our firms build plans that last and stand out in a market, because your advice has never been needed more. Thank you.